feet are in the dirt, and my butt was in the dirt. And a stick went somewhere weird, and I thought it was a bug. Hello friends, welcome back to another video. Today I have another crystal haul. What? Yes, all these items are from the same place I showed in my last haul. I will link it down below. And I'll just go ahead and get started because it's already in my hand. The first item I got is this larger fade-in quartz point. And this one actually has a story to it. One day, a few weeks ago, I woke up and, just about every day, I wake up and I have this feeling. The only way I can describe it is a million tiny orgasms all over my skin. That's how I've been waking up for the past 2.5 years. That's a whole other thing. Whatever, I can talk about in another video, but it was especially in my hands. And the only way I can describe it in my hands specifically was like angelic. Something was in my hands. Oh, and I have a tingle right here now. Okay, anyways. I didn't really have much planned for the day. Most of my days I am free to plan because I don't have a job where I go to regularly or any kind of commitment like that right now. My main focus is building my business, so I do that on my own time, and I enjoy that I'm able to do that. So that was basically the only thing I had to do that day. And most of the time I try to get outside for about 30 minutes, take a walk, enjoy the sunlight, enjoy the nature, the fresh air, and I prefer to walk places if it's walking distance. So, I was walking to one of my local coffee shops to work on my business. And, for whatever reason, I stopped into this store that I knew about, that I've seen, but I never went in there. And it was the homeware store. But, I was amazed to see so many crystals in there. And on top of that, they had a whole bunch of other metaphysical things, different books and candles, and just, it was a homeware store, but it was more like metaphysical homeware, I guess. I was really drawn to not this one. This one had a twin brother there, and I was really drawn to that crystal, and I was just holding it while I was browsing around the store, while I was talking to the employee. I was obsessed with that crystal, and I told her, I said, when I woke up this morning, I had this feeling in my hands that I could only describe as angelic. And I'm like, and I'm obsessed with this crystal, and I'm thinking the crystal called me over here. And she's like, I think it did too. And I didn't end up buying it that day, just because I didn't have the money. But I thought, that crystal, it's for me. And when something is for you, it's for you. No one else can take it, That goes with anything in life. So I left the store that day. And, throughout the next few weeks, I would pop in the store and I would visit my crystal. I would hold it. I would look at the other stuff, and I'd look at the price. And I'd be like, one day I'll get it. And so the day that I bought the candles in the other haul, I picked up the crystal and I was like, wait a minute. I couldn't remember which crystal it was. Because I said, this is the twin sister. The other one was the brother. And I was like, wait, which one was my crystal? They look so similar. And I was like, when I saw this one, I was like, no, it's this one. And And then when I took it home, I was like, you know what? No, it wasn't this one. Because as you can see in the close-up, you'll be able to see there's some little other crystals growing on the side. And also, this one is a little bit dirty. I remember that other one was super smooth and clear. That's pretty much how you can tell if it's a male crystal, if it's see-through, if it's more gem quality. And I was like, you know what? But I'm so happy to have this one. But I just thought to myself, you know what? It's just not time for me to have the brother. And I said, when the time comes, I'll bring home the brother too. And I'll have my two fade in quartz point twins. But anyways, yeah, I'm just going to read you what... Oh, and I didn't even tell you. Blah, 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 blah. So yesterday I met up with one of my friends that I haven't, seen in a long time. And recently she's always been into metaphysical stuff, but she never really got into it. She was, attracted to it. She had experiences, but she never really tapped into it. So she's been seeing me post all the time. She's like, Michelle, I got to talk to you, girl. We got to talk about this because I want to learn and blah, blah, blah. So we ended up spending the whole day. We had coffee, we talked and talked and talked. Then we went to a few different crystal stores, and that's when I got this one. And I told myself, you know what? Before I left the house, I said, if we end up going to that store, that's it. I'm going to get it. I have to get it. And I got it. Okay, let me read you about fading crystals, or fading quartz. I have never heard of this one before. And I'm going to refer to the Crystal Bible 2. It's the second edition of the Crystal Bible by Judy Hall. And it says here, color, white, appearance, clear flat crystal with distinctive thread-like line. Easily available worldwide. Attributes. Fading quartz has fractured during its growth and healed again, forming a visible line. And this crystal unifies the self too, encouraging fragmented soul parts to reintegrate, symbolizing the silver cord, tethering the etheric body to the physical during out-of-body experiences. This stone provides protection during journeying. Placed on the soma chakra, fading quartz reels the soul back to the body and can activate the upper portion of a cosmic anchor. Spiritually, fading quartz provides a link to the higher self, helpful during past life regression and for entering the between life state. It provides an overview of soul lessons and root causes of dis-ease. Psychologically, if you are undergoing intense internal trauma, fading quartz gives you the strength to carry on. And I really resonated with that. Again, I didn't know what this was. I didn't know what it was about. And when I read what it was about, I was like, girl, no wonder. No wonder it was calling my name. Emotionally, fading quartz helps to heal broken trust in relationships and teaches how to have both emotional autonomy and be intimate with another person. Uniting personal love with the divine, it encourages loving yourself from within, your own heart, inducing emotional stability and harmonizing extremes. This stone calms the emotional body when placed on the solar plexus. By bridging gaps, the crystal harmonizes the energies of a group or family, particularly if the intention is to overcome conflict or heal a break. Girl, promoting communication during the healing process. When working at a distance, fading quartz helps connect healer and patient. What do I do for a living? Crystal healing. And I do long distance healings. So that's great. It enhances self-healing and personal growth. Purifies the biomagnetic sheath and harmonizes chakra energy flow, opening all but especially the crown and past life chakras. Exactly what I need right now. Environmentally, fading quartz efficiently grids areas of unstable earth or physical energy to regain equilibrium, Healing supports the healings of breaks and fractures, cysts and incrustations, and back pain. What do I struggle with? Back pain! Okay. Bringing stability at all levels, it assists cellular memory and inner alignment, which is all, this is all what I'm going through, girl. Trying to align myself, trying to heal myself, trying to heal all these relationships and blah, 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 blah. Girl, love it. And honestly, when I was in my room the other night, or actually last night, and I was writing in my journal, I had this sitting on my shelf, and I was like, I just felt its presence, girl. Like, I didn't even look at it. I felt, you know? I don't know. This is the first crystal that I had that experience with, where I felt like, because honestly, people, if you don't know too much about crystals, crystals are beings. They're not lifeless. This is the first time that I actually felt like, you know, like, what? Who's there? And it's my crystal, you know? I don't know. Okay. So then, the second crystal I got, this is actually the first one. You know how when you walk into a store, you just kind of like gravitate towards something? This is the first thing I gravitated towards. So it's a raw chunk of amethyst. And I've never had I did have a raw little piece of amethyst that I was gifted. One of my other crystal vendor friends, she gave it to me it was my first pop-up healing event that I went to. And I ended up gifting it to one of my clients. So I really liked, you know, the shape of this. I think the length, the texture, and honestly, I just like to hold it like this. Like, I don't know. And I kept on like pressing it on my face. And it really, I mean, the crystal was cool. I mean, it's cool right now. And one of the properties of amethyst is, you know, to calm you down, to soothe anxiety, to help you sleep, and it's also good for your skin. So I just thought this was a really unique piece that I had nothing like, and I mean, I connected with it. That's it. That's all you really need to know. But yeah, I'm really excited to use this on my clients, and also continue to use it for myself. It's just super, I just love it. I love it so much. Just love holding it in my hand. It's just, I don't know, I really like it. And then my friend and I were in there for so long, looking and looking and looking, talking and talking and talking, talking with the store employee, who was super cool. And then we had to take a break because we're like, man, we have to go to the bathroom. So we went to the bathroom, we came back, finished up our decisions, and then we finally purchased our stuff. So when I was gonna pay for my stuff, I saw they had this Ember and Stone Quartz Apothecary Selenite Smudge Spray. It's a quartz infused mystic spray. So it's basically similar to, if you watched my product release video, to my Abundance Spray. This Ember and Stone company, that's the same company that I got my candles from the other day. And I thought this was really unique because it has selenite. And if you guys know, selenite dissolves in water. So it's cool that she infused it in that way. Like, it's dissolved in here. It's not a chunk in there. You know, like in my Abundant Spray, I have pieces of citrine, and the citrine doesn't break down in water. So I don't know. I just thought that was really unique. And she also, there's also a tiny little piece of quartz in here too. I mean, I always use sprays when I do pop-up healing events, just because a lot of them don't allow you to burn any kind of sage or Palo Santo or incense. Part of it is because, a lot of pop-up healing events that I do, they kind of have a guideline, like no cultural appropriation or misuse of sacred gifts. And so that's part of it. And also too, just some people don't like the smell of those things. And honestly, to me, that's an indication that they have really bad energy, because the smoke from the Palo Santo and the sage is supposed to be cleansing. And if you don't like it, that means you really need it, girl. But, you know, that's just how it is. So I usually just carry sprays and essential oils with me. When I also do healings privately in my home or in a client's house, I also use sprays too, just because that's part of my, you know, aromatherapy that I incorporate in my healing. If you guys watched my room tour, my feng shui room tour, you know, I'm learning more about feng shui, and basically wherever there's darkness in a room, that's basically where bad energy can collect or energy can stagnate. And the whole point of feng shui, the whole point of macrobiotics, is to keep your energy flowing. You know, that's the best way to live the best life emotionally, physically, you know, to attract what you want, to achieve what you want. So I noticed I had a spot in my room that was dark, and I saw I had a little outlet, and I was like, oh, you know what would look cute if I got a like salt lamp nightlight, or like if you guys have seen different crystal nightlights. And but they didn't have them the other day when I went, but when I was checking out, they had them on the table. Like, she was gonna set them up or whatever. So I said, oh, are you guys selling them? She said, yeah. And there was a few, and I was kind of looking at all of them. And I picked up this one first, and then I was starting to look at the others. And then the employee said, you know what, Michelle? Well, she didn't say my name, but she's like, you know what? I kind of get intuitive hits, you know, when the customer's in the store, and I kind of feel like I know what they're gonna buy, or like I kind of feel like, you know, what is a good fit for their energy. That's what she said. And she said, I think that one is a good fit for you. So I ended up choosing this one. And I really like the effect it gives my room. It's like a pinky orangey glow in that area. And then plus, you know, I have my other Himalayan salt lamp, but that one changes colors, so it's just a nice little addition. And the last thing I got from the store, I actually saw it the other day when I got my candles, and it really called out to me, partly because it was just the Sagittarius full moon, and the other part was that my astrologer, if you guys don't follow Hidden Gift Astrology on Instagram or on YouTube, I'm gonna link her information down below. She's my personal astrologer. I have a subscription with her, so every month we do a video call, and she updates me about the transits of the planets, how it affects me. You know, I can ask her whatever questions I want. And she's also partnered with me for my online program. So if you sign up early for my online program, you get an hour-long session with her. And you could do your birth chart. You could talk about, you know, whatever you want to. If you want to learn more about my online program, I will always have the link down below so you can book a call with me. But she suggested, because I'm a Cancer sun, I was born July 11th. That makes me a Cancer. That's my sun sign. She suggested, Michelle, you know, Cancer is ruled by the moon. I think it's a really good idea for you to start getting into, you know, lunar energy. And honestly, people, that is something I've always been interested in getting into. I just never really knew, like, how do I get into it? Like, what, you know, like I had this other friend, Obsidiana. I will link her down below too. She's such a great resource. She was the one that kind of first talked about lunar energy, and I was just like, how do you even get into it? What is even? And then I saw this book, da 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 da, The Moon Journal, A Journey of Self-Reflection Through the Astrological Year. And I mean, it just looks beautiful. And so basically what it is, I mean, it has beautiful artwork. It kind of teaches you about the moon and the cycles, you know, all of it. But then it relates it to what's happening in the sun sign. So during each sign of the zodiac, it talks about the theme of the sun sign and how it coordinates or relates to the moon. Because this is something I underlined in the book that I knew, but I never really like thought about it, is that the moon is a reflection of the sun. It's a reflection, you know? And it kind of goes along with what I'm into, you know, with macrobiotics, with crystals, you know, by getting yourself in line with nature, with your environment, with the universe, things just start to become easier for you. You know, health problems start to disappear. You naturally become happier. Things in your life, better things are attracted to you. You know, just overall, you upgrade your quality of life. And the fact that they talk about that, getting in line with the energy of the sun and the moon, specifically the moon, you know, to help you manifest, which is exactly what I've been working on with the law of attraction. Like, what, girl? So I was so excited to get this. And it also is like a journal too. So it has different prompts. You know, like yesterday I was working on it. And let's see what it talks about Gemini, because this is the last day of Gemini. It talks about like, yeah. You can like fill in the numbers like of the day, and you can like fill in the different moons for like the different cycles of the moon. And it says like here, the affirmation for Gemini is, I am open to growth and learning. So accurate for this whole month. And it has different things, like Gemini is an air sign, talks about Gemini being an air sign. Says Gemini is a mutable sign, talks about Gemini being a mutable sign. Gemini is a personal sign, talks about, you know, that. And then it says, if you are a Gemini, so if it is your birth month. And then it has different little prompts here to write and journal. And so I'm so excited to work through that. I'm so excited to learn. So, I mean, duh, it's Gemini season. Okay. Anyways, that is all I got in my haul today. Just one more thing. I'll just give a shout out to my friends, the Higher Channel 777. They custom made this arm band for me. I have been wearing it as just a regular bracelet, honestly, just because I don't know if it's because my arms are not toned right now, but it just doesn't stay on my upper arm where it's supposed to. So I still think it's cute as like a little wraparound bracelet, but they put a tiger's eye and they put a citrine. And I also partnered with the Higher Channel 777 for my online program. And when you sign up early for my online program, you will also get a custom made crystal crown. So that's another incentive for you to book a call with me and find out what my program is all about. And so many exciting things are coming up in regards to that, but it's still under construction. So stay tuned, and I will see you guys in my next video. Thank you so much for watching. Peace, and also, think differently. This would be a cute picture. Someone screenshot it.